So hi everyone and welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session guys, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are important for each and every exam of the Government of India or any state government. So let's begin with the session without any delay. But before we begin, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after its completion and you can also ask any doubt here. And you can also follow me here. This is my Instagram ID. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which is regarding the national scheme for PM Poshan. Consider the following statements with respect to continuation of national scheme for PM Poshan and you have to identify the incorrect statement. Guys, please don't get confused. National scheme of for PM Poshan is nothing but midday meal. The new name of this scheme. मिडडे मील स्कीम अर्लियर इट वॉज नोन एज यू ऑल नो मिडडे मील स्कीम के बारे में आप आई होप आप सबने सुना होगा सो मिडडे मील स्कीम इज नाउ नेशनल स्कीम फॉर पीएम पोषण ऑलराइट एंड इट हैज बीन कंटिन्यूड फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 5 years एंड दैट इज व्हाई इट इज इन न्यूज सो हियर यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट आउट ऑफ दीज फोर ऑलराइट सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द न्यूज व्हाट इज द न्यूज सो रिमेंबर द कैबिनेट कमेटी ऑन इकोनॉमिक अफेयर्स Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs has approved the continuation of National Scheme for PM Poshan, which is nothing but midday meal scheme. Let me repeat this. This is nothing but midday meal. Please don't get confused. Okay, इसमें confused होने वाली कोई बात नहीं है. And it has been extended, or you can say it has been continued for a period of 5 years, starting from this financial year to financial year 2026. And these are the financial outlay that has been announced by the government of India. So central government share will be rupees 54061.73 crores. State government share will be 317.17 crores. And additional cost of about rupees 45,000 crore will be borne by the central government for procurement of food grains. All right. And total budget, agar hum dekhen, to kitna hoga iska 130794.90 crores. Now these data guys are very difficult to remember. So अगर याद हो जाता है इफ यू आर एबल टू रिमेंबर दिस देन दैट इज ओके अदरवाइज देयर इज नो मतलब दीज नंबर्स आर नॉट सो मच इम्पॉर्टेंट ओके अगर बट फिर भी आई वुड रिकमेंड कि याद कर लो ठीक है 10-15 बार पढ़ लोगे तो ऑफकोर्स याद हो जाएगा नाउ टॉकिंग अबाउट द स्कीम सो रिमेंबर गाइज द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द स्कीम इज टू इम्प्रूव द न्यूट्रिशनल लेवल अमंग द चिल्ड्रन टू इम्प्रूव द न्यूट्रिशनल लेवल अमंग द चिल्ड्रन एंड ऑल्सो to enhance the retention and enhance the attendance in the school okay so improving nutritional levels among children and also to enhance enrollment retention attendance of the children in school all right this scheme was launched in the year 1995 as national program of nutritional support to primary education but in the year 2004 it was renamed or you can say it was relaunched by the name midday meal scheme but now it is now again renamed as national scheme for PM Poshan all right it is being implemented by ministry of education and it is the coverage agar hum coverage ki baat kare so all the students from class 1st to 8 who are enrolled in government school government aided school local body schools special training centers madrasas and maktab supported under sarva shiksha abhiyan so ye sabhi students cover kiye jate hain under the midday meal scheme which is now National Scheme for PM Poshan. Now talking about the funding, so it is a centrally sponsored scheme. This I hope आपको समझ में आ गया होगा because starting में हमने पढ़ा financial outlay was divided between the central government and the state government and the ratio is what 60:40 and these are the calories intake as per the midday meal scheme. So if we talk about energy, so in primary school 450 calorie, in upper primary it is 700 calorie. If you talk about the protein, then 12 grams for primary school and 20 grams for upper primary school. All right. Now moving ahead to some of the new changes that have been introduced in this particular scheme. So number one change is that the scheme will be extended to students studying in pre-primary or Bal Vatikas of government and government-aided schools. Bal Vatikas mein bhi abhi scheme ko extend kiya jayega. Also, Tithi Bhojan will be encouraged extensively. Now, what is this Tithi Bhojan? Tithi Bhojan basically guys it is a community based program it is a community participation program you can say it is a community participation program in which people offer special food to children on some special festival or occasion okay social audit of the scheme is made mandatory in all the districts across the country involvement of FPOs and women SHGs to इसके इम्प्लीमेंटेशन के लिए एफपीओस को और वुमेन एसएचजीस को भी अब रोल इन किया जाएगा, एंड ऑफ कोर्स स्पेशल प्रोविजन फॉर प्रोवाइडिंग सप्लीमेंट्री न्यूट्रिशन टू चिल्ड्रन इन एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स एंड दोज डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स विच हैव द हाई प्रेवलेंस ऑफ एनीमिया। ओके, एस्पिरेशनल डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स में और ऐसे डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स में जहां पे एनीमिया का प्रेवलेंस बहुत ज्यादा है, देयर द स्पेशल प्रोविजंस हैव बीन मेड फॉर इंप्लीमेंटिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर स्कीम। ओके, सो दिस वाज अबाउट दिस न्यूज गाइज, एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन। यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट। द स्कीम हैज बीन कंटिन्यूड फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 5 years, दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट। सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट विल प्रोवाइड 504061.73 करोड़ एज द फाइनेंशियल असिस्टेंस, यस दिस इज ऑल्सो करेक्ट, एंड रिमेंबर इट इज अ सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम एंड द फंडिंग रेशियो इज 60-40। सोशल ऑडिट ऑफ द स्कीम इज मेड मैंडेटरी इन ऑल द डिस्ट्रिक्ट, यस दिस इज अगेन करेक्ट, एंड द स्कीम विल बी एक्सटेंडेड टू द स्टूडेंट्स स्टडिंग इन प्री प्राइमरी और बालवाटिकास। सो ऑल द स्टेटमेंट्स आर एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट, विच मीन्स ऑप्शन ई नन इज करेक्ट विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर। Now let's move ahead to question number 2. Yes, question number 2 says, with which of the following enterprises CSIR Institute of Minerals and Material Technology has signed an MOU for development of indigenous technology for making the Indian mineral industry self-reliant? Now guys, in this particular question, you just have to remember 2-3 things. Number 1, the objective of MOU, and number 2, with which organization this MOU has been signed by CSIR IMMT. Okay, and this organization, guys, let me tell you, is National Mineral Development Corporation, NMDC. National Mineral Development Corporation is the correct answer. And what is the objective of this MOU? To develop certain technologies so that the Indian mineral industry can be made self-reliant. Okay, now talking about NMDC, so it is a government enterprise under the Ministry of Steel. It is a government enterprise under the Ministry of Steel. It was established in the year 1958. It is headquartered in Hyderabad. And Mr. Sumit Dev is the CMD. Of NMDC. Alright, so option D is the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 3. NSC Foundation, in collaboration with which organization, is acting as a technical partner in operationalizing the Elderline toll-free helpline number? Now, if you remember, in the month of May 2020, this Elderline toll-free helpline number was launched to provide COVID-related information to the elderly people. But now, this Elderline helpline has been extended to provide all the related information to the old age people. Alright. So, the question is regarding with which organization NEC Foundation is collaborating for implementation of this. So, let's talk about the Elderline first, then we will come back to the question. So, it is a pan-India toll-free helpline number for senior citizens for providing various information related to pension, related to legal, pension issues, legal issues, and it also extend emotional support to the elderly who have no one in this world, jinke bete, beti ne unko chhod diya hai, ya fir agar unka koi bhi nahi hai. So, emotional support will also be provided through this particular toll-free helpline number, Elderline. Alright, it was launched in May 2021, and NSE Foundation along with Tata Trust. NEC Foundation along with Tata Trust are the technical partners in operationalizing the project. And what is the number? 14567. 14567. And if you also know any old age person who is in the need of some kind of emotional support or any kind of guidance, then you should also recommend that person this about this Elderline project of the Government of India. And it is being implemented, of course, by Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. All right. So, now let's come back to the question. The correct answer, guys, would be option B, Tata Trust. Alright. Now moving ahead to question number 4. By which year dog-mediated rabies is to be eliminated from the country as per the National Action Plan for Dog-Mediated Rabies? Now, this National Action Plan, guys, has been recently launched by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare and along with, in consultation with Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairy. Now, in this particular plan, you just have to remember that the target year for eliminating the dog mediated rabies. Is plan ko detail mein padhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai. There is no need to study about this plan in detail, because they are not going to ask that how they will eliminate the rabies by 2030. They will just ask by which year they will according to this plan the rabies will be eliminated from country. All right, so let's talk about this news. Remember, the Minister of Health and Family Welfare, Mr. Mansukh Mandavia, and Minister of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying, Mr. Purushottam Rupala. They both have launched this national action plan for dog mediated rabies, and according to this plan, the rabies will be eliminated from India by the year 2030. 2030 तक हमें eliminate करना है. And remember, this plan has been drafted by National Center for Diseases Control in consultation with the Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairying. All right. तो इसमें इतना ही पढ़ना, बस ये 2030 वाला ही question आएगा. या ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा they can also ask that which organization has drafted this particular plan. So in that case, the answer would be National Center for Disease Control. All right. So therefore, guys, the correct answer will be what? Option C, 2030 will be the correct answer. Moving ahead to question number 5. With which municipal corporation Indraprastha Gas Limited has signed an MOU to set up a waste to energy plant? So remember, this municipal corporation, guys, is South Delhi Municipal Corporation. South Delhi Municipal Corporation. So with SDMC, this MOU has been signed by Indraprastha Gas Limited. Now, what is the objective of this MOU? So to set up a waste to energy plant in Delhi to convert municipal solid waste into compressed biogas for use as a fuel for vehicles. Okay, basically a plant, waste to energy plant set up karna chahte hain, and for that this MOU has been signed. Remember, this plant will be set up under the Satat initiative. Satat initiative. Now Satat stands for sustainable, I'm forgetting the full form, towards affordable sustainable, I think action. A stands for action towards affordable transportation. I am forgetting about this A. Sustainable something A towards affordable transportation. I beg your pardon, guys, for this. I'm forgetting the full form of this. Sustainable. Okay, I'm sorry. Let me check the full form of Satat. I'm forgetting the, yes, that's alternative. Sustainable alternative for sustainable alternative towards affordable transportation is the full form of Satat. And under this particular initiative, the government will set up 5,000 compressed biogas plant under this particular initiative. And what is the full form? Sustainable alternative towards affordable transportation. Now the expected production of this CBG is how much? 4,000 kg per day. All right. So the correct answer will be what? South Delhi Municipal Corporation, option A will be the correct answer. Now let's move ahead to question number 6. Bahut chota question aur bahut asaan hai. Name the challenge that has been launched by Dr. Jitendra Singh. He is the Minister of Science and Technology and also the Minister of Earth Sciences. His Lok Sabha constituency is in Jammu and Kashmir, Udhampur. Jammu and Kashmir mein Udhampur naam ki jagah hai, wo unki Lok Sabha constituency hai. To identify 75 startup innovations in telemedicine, digital health, m-health with big data, AI, blockchain and other technologies. So remember, guys, this challenge is named as JanCare. This challenge is named as JanCare, and do remember that this challenge, what is the objective of this challenge? To identify 75 startup innovations in these areas. Okay, isme itna hi padhna hai, isse zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai. Now ye jitne bhi challenge wagaira hote hain usme sirf do hi cheeze important hoti hai, teen cheeze. Who, which ministry or which organization has launched this, the objective and the name. All right, isse zyada padhne ki koi zarurat nahi hoti ki challenge mein kya karenge, kitna prize denge, kitna award denge. These things are not important for the exam. Okay, so JanCare here is the correct answer, option A. And that's it for the session, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.